the importance of oxygen for survival of life on the planet. Oxygen producing and oxygen consuming microorganisms are present in aquatic environment. They act as producers in the aquatic ecosystem upon which the other organisms survive. Microbes present in the freshwater bodies help to maintain the desired oxygen levels in water. A variety of microorganisms which are present in deep surfaces help in the process of bioremediation. Bioremediation refers to cleanup of oil, toxic chemicals, or other pollutants from the environment. They help to remove toxic substances which leach out from soil into the groundwaters and deep surfaces. Human beings release various synthetic compounds in the surroundings, xenobiotic compounds which do not occur naturally. For example, pesticides, dyes, solvents, etc. Microorganisms help degradation of such harmful substances. To name a few of them, the bacterial species responsible for heavy metal reduction are Gemella species, Micrococcus species, and Hafnia species. Microbes are very useful in leaching process, which involves use of microbes to recover metals from their low-grade ores. They prove to be very helpful in recovery of mainly copper and also gold and uranium. There are some microbes which also produce petroleum, particularly certain green algae. In the terrestrial environments, the most significant effect of the microorganisms is their ability to recycle the primary elements that make up all living systems, especially carbon, oxygen, and nitrogen.
Microbes play a very important role in nutrient cycling.
The microbes ensure that all the essential elements are made available for all other life forms in the desired form. Microorganisms play a very important role in decomposition or biodegradation, which results in the breakdown of complex organic materials to forms of carbon that can be used by other organisms. In the plant world, leguminous plants, that is peas, beans, clover, alfalfa, live in intimate associations with bacteria that extract nitrogen from the atmosphere and supply it to the plant for growth. Nitrogen fixation is a process found only in some bacteria which removes nitrogen from the atmosphere and converts it to ammonia, that is NH3, for use by plants and animals. Nitrogen fixation also results in replenishment of soil nitrogen removed by agricultural process. Some bacteria fix nitrogen in symbiotic associations in plants. Other nitrogen-fixing bacteria are free living in soil and aquatic habitats. Have you seen the roots and plantlet of groundnut or fenugreek? There are small nodules on the roots. Try doing this experiment yourself. Wash these roots, dip them into hydrogen peroxide and then in 70% ethyl alcohol for 4 to 5 minutes. Clean the roots with sterile water and take thin sections of root nodules. Place it in a solution of safranin for 2 to 3 minutes. Place the stained section of glass slide and observe it under the compound microscope. The pinkish rod-shaped organisms are the rhizobia. Lichens consist of mutualistic relationship between a fungus and alga. Lichens colonize on the surface where other organisms do not grow. Thus, this kind of association initiates the colonization process in the environment. Mycorrhizae are mutualistic associations between plant roots and fungi. The fungus helps plant to absorb nutrients from poor soils. Microbes in the rumen of cows, sheep, and other ruminant animals are responsible for the initial digestion of nutrients, primarily cellulose. And they provide not only source of carbon for their host, but also source of proteins and vitamins.